I'm here today to introduce a series of videos that we are going to be taking from the program called Business Intelligence and Data Analytics. So students will be showcasing the various material that they are engaged in this program. It's an honors program, it's a new program. So we just want to show you what we are all about. And this first video of the series that we are holding is on data mining. So you are going to be taught how to mine data, what does data mining mean in the first place, and how it can help businesses to make huge profits and retain their employees. Thank you very much.
Hi guys, this is Arnold Masole, a BDA student with Business Intelligence and Data Analytics student at Botswana Accountancy College, class of 2017 to 2021. Today we'll be talking to you guys about data mining. Well, first I would like to outline our objectives to you guys. Our first objective would be to define data mining. And then our second objective would be to state the reasons for data mining. Our third objective would be the data mining process itself, how it goes and how it's done. Our fourth objective would be to state the type of data mining processes that are there, because that could be. Let me get on to our first objective. Data mining as a significant process of discovering interesting and knowledgeable patterns in large sets of data. Most times data mining can also be referred to KDD, knowledge discovered in databases. Well, I must correct you, or I must state that KDD is not data mining, but rather is a process of data mining. Now let's go back to the keywords within our explanation. It says interesting should be interesting and knowledgeable. You do not just discover anything. You have to look for it. It's a process. Data mining is a process of discovering interesting and knowledgeable patterns in large sets of data. Then I think we're going to progress on to our second objective, which is to state why there's a need for data mining, the reasons we do data mining. Well, first of all, as you know, we're living in a large world, and obviously in a large world there is ample amount of data that comes in. As we have massive growth of data, data has grown, has expanded from terabytes to petabytes. There are large amounts of data collected and available from different sources, be it business, be it science, be it society. Take a look at, for example, you can take a look at transactions that take place in a bank, hypotheses that are developed by scientists, and messages we pass or we exchange together within the society. That's a whole lot of data. And if that data is mined, we can extract knowledge. In simple terms, what I'm trying to say is that we have ample data but lack knowledge, hence the large need for data mining. Data mining enables us to mine the data so that we can extract knowledge for better use. Another reason why we would mine data is because there is large availability of quantity data. This one, I would say, it's more similar to the first reason, but in a different way. Here we're talking about quality data, and anything that is of quality can benefit us. That's the need for data mining. You can take an example of Facebook and a Trojan business. If a Trojan business invests into extracting data or mining data in Facebook databases, it would be profitable to them because they are able to extract knowledgeable or interesting data from their databases that they can use to that benefit. Say there's something trending, there's something new trending on Facebook, right? and this company, it's a clothing company, and it goes on to Facebook and it expressed that before its competitors, it's profitable to them because they're gonna work on producing what is trending, what is pleasing to people. And so enticing a whole lot of us, right? Then going on to our third point, we mandated because of the consolidation and integration of data repositories into data warehouses. What this one means is that we have a whole lot of data, like I stated before, we have data from different sources, be it business, be it science, be it society, and it's all integrated into one place. You would never know which is which, it's all mixed data. So we use data mining to extract what we specifically need from the data warehouses. Because the data that is combined, it's not really structured into the sectors that we would want. So data mining is needed to extract specific piece of data that we would like to look at. Another point would be that it would be of market analysis and management. We mine data on targeted markets, cross-selling, market segmentation. And now let's get on to target market. Target market is the clients you are aiming. And then cross-selling would be international trading. And then market segmentation would be the different markets you target. The type of market you target. Would it be you're targeting men, you're targeting females, you're targeting a certain age description? So with that, with data mining, it's helpful to get, since data mining deals with patterns, it's easier with data mining to identify data with related patterns so that you can use it for analysis, market analysis and management. And then we have another point that talks about fraud detection or the detection of unusual patterns. This one would take a look at bank transactions, for instance. Say money goes missing, okay? I'd say this is where data mining comes in. The bank would have to use data mining, right, to actually analyze, to evaluate the patterns within the transactions and see where something went wrong. You can identify an unusual pattern within the transactions and actually be able to solve such mysteries. So what I just stated, guys, are the main reasons why we basically need data mining. Data mining would be, I would say, is starting to be the core of our society. Now we get on to the data mining process. That is our third objective. Data mining process. Now I'm going to give you a small but detailed diagram of the data mining process. Thank you. data is acquired and loaded into the databases, it's cleaned. Now, this happens when it goes through the ETL process, that is the extraction, transformation, and loading process, I meant, not system. And then after it's cleaned, it's loaded into the data warehouses, where structure is imposed to data. And then afterwards, the data is taken, the data is selected according to what you're looking for in specific, be it business, be it whatever you might want to mine from the data. So you select specific data you would want to mine, right? Then eventually you do mine the data. When you mine the data, you acquire patterns, and these patterns are evaluated. And then evaluated. After evaluating all your patterns, the patterns that you got, you acquired from data mining, you evaluate them, right? After evaluating them, you acquire knowledge. This is the knowledge that you use for a whole lot of stuff, decision making. Yeah, for new knowledge found, that would be it. And then we get on to the meaning of data. We keep on talking about data mining. So now, what is data and data mining? As it's commonly known, data is a collection of facts from experiences, from experiments, from observations. It can also consist of numbers, words, images. Data is just, you know, that. But data can be divided into two parts. It can be into the structured part. There's structured data, which consists of categorical and numerical data. Then we have unstructured data, which consists of textual data, multimedia, and HTML. And when we talk about textual data, we mean the type of data we exchange between each other. When we tweet, that's textual. It's text you find within emails, text you find within books and stuff like that. That's textual data. Then we have multimedia. Multimedia would be the data acquired from images, from videos, from audio, anything to do with media. Then we have the HTML. HTML would be website coding. That's data we get from source codes and codings on the codings on websites and stuff like that. Then we have data mining can also be classified into two parts. Into descriptive data mining and predictive data mining. I think now we'll proceed to another objective, that is the relation between data mining and business intelligence. Here we evaluate the relationship between data mining and business intelligence. Now let's first get what business intelligence is, right? Business intelligence is a process of analyzing data and presenting it as actionable information to executives to use for decision making. It's helpful. It's basically analyzing data so that you present it to your executables that they may use it in their decision making process. We can say that data mining helps in data in decision making, and the question we would ask is how? You see, when data mining is used to discover, extract knowledge, right? And from it's used to discover and extract knowledge from data, right? And that knowledge would then be used for decision making process in business intelligence. That's how they are linked. And the simple process would be that data sources provide the data, right? And then the data is pre-processed. Data is explored. When you explore data, that's when data mining comes in. And data is eventually mined. And after the extraction of knowledge, it's presented to the executables. That's where the business intelligence part comes in. Then finally, it comes to decision-making process being able. Now we get to another objective, the one that states the types of patterns. We keep talking about data mining being a process of discovering interesting and knowledgeable patterns. Now let's get more into what those patterns are. We have association patterns, we have classification or clustering patterns, we have sequence patterns, and we have trend analysis. I'll start with explaining just a brief explanation of those patterns. We start with the classification or clustering pattern. It's a group, when we talk about a cluster, we talk about a group. So classification or clustering pattern is, it's basically finding data that is in a group that has similar characters, and it's, yeah, clustered. Then we have sequence. This is data sequence patterns. These are patterns found in data with structure according to precedence. Then we have trend analysis. It would be patterns of what is trending, what is popular. You know, trend is trending, what is popular is circulating amongst us, right? And then we get to the different perspectives to view data mining. First of all, you can mine data looking at the data to be mined, the knowledge to be mined, the techniques you're gonna utilize, and the applications that are adopted. Now, when we talk about the data to be mined, it could be data from different sources, right? It could be data from RDWs, relational data warehouses, from transactions, from screens, on the screens, from time series, from text, and multimedia. It's a whole lot. So when you mine data, there's a perspective that you have to view. The type of data you want to mine, the type of data to be mined, is it transactional, is it online, is it streaming, is it time series, is it multimedia? You have to look at that. You have to, yeah. It's a perspective one has to look before carrying out the data mining process. You have to also identify the knowledge to be mined, right? What exactly do you want to acquire from data mining? This one has to be characterized, classified, and associated. You specify the patterns, not really specify. You have to be able to determine which type of patterns you'd like to acquire from the whole process. And then you have techniques to be used or utilized. You have to mine the techniques that you are going to use. We have three techniques, would be OLA, online analysis process, the machine language, the statistics, and visualization. So you'd have to look at such things, the techniques that you are going to need to implement for you to carry out the data mining process. Then we have applications adapted. You look at the data you are to mine, or what type of applications have they adapted. Is it telecommunication? Is it banking? Is it biodata? Is it stock market, CRM, retailing, or insurance? You have to pay close attention to that. Then when we move on to another objective, the types of process of data mining processes. We have the CRISP data mining process, which is called the cross-industrial standard process for data mining. We have the SEMA, the sample, explore, modify, model, and assess process. And then we have the KDD. Remember, when we first started, I mentioned that most people confuse KDD to be data mining, whereas KDD is a type of data mining process. KDD stands for Knowledge Discovery in Databases. Now I'm gonna have a short discussion of cross industry standard process. That's CRISP-DM. The first step you would take in Christia would be to understand your business understanding. The first step, this is to understand what the customer wants to accomplish from a business perspective. The analyst's goal is to uncover important factors that could influence the outcome of the project. Neglecting this one step would mean a lot of effort is put into getting the right answers to the wrong questions. This is basically to understand what you'd want to use data mining to uncover. If you do not state or outline what your goal is to achieve from data mining, then you'll be mining data and getting the right answers, but to the wrong needs, to the wrong questions. Our second step is data understanding. In the second phase, you compile your data, you verify that it's appropriate to your needs. And then our third step is to prepare data. Here, data is selected, clean, constructed, integrated, and formatted. The first step would be data modeling. In this phase, we select the actual modeling technique to be used, a specific technique. Remember, we were talking about techniques previously. Whether to use the decision tree building with C5.0. And then we have the fifth step, which is to evaluate. You evaluate not only the model, but also the process that you use to create them and the potential for practical use. This one basically talks about evaluating your models and the process that took you to that actual model, which technique, which process you implemented to create that specific model. Then deployment, you implement the model you came up with. Then one thing to note here is that if you get the first step wrong, then know that you're just going to get everything, these other steps all wrong. Because if you do not outline your goals and needs or business understanding well, then basically you're just getting the wrong answers, the right answers to the wrong question. And that's a whole lot of work done for nothing. Then we get to SAMA, another type of data mining. SAMA, as we said, stands for sample, explore, modify, model, and assess. When you sample, you generate a representative sample of the data. Then when you explore the data, you visualize and give a basic description of the data. When you modify it, you select variable and transform variable representation. Now, when we come to modeling, we use a variety of techniques. Say it's statistical or machine learning techniques to model the item, to model your information. Then when you assess it, you evaluate the accuracy and usefulness of the model, right? That would be all from me. Thank you for paying attention, and thank you for joining us. That would be all.